All right, Canto 15. Still the seventh circle, third ring, the violent against God, second zone, the sodomites, endless crossing the fiery sands beneath the rain of fire. Brunetto, Latini, whom Dante treats as Mento, Prision, Francesco di Accorso, and Andrea de Mozzi, Bishop of Florence. Now one of the hard borders bears us forward, the river mist forms shadows overhead and shields the shores and water from the fire. Just as between Wissant and Bruges, the Flemings, in terror of the tide that floods towards them, have built a wall of dikes to taunt the sea, or to daunt the sea. And as the Padawans along the Brenta build bulwarks to defend their towns and castles before the dog days fall on Carentana, just so were these embankments, even though they were not built so high and not so broad, whoever was the artisan who made them. By now we were so distant from the wood that I should not have made out where it was, not even if I turn around and look. When we came on a company of spirits who made their way along the bank, and each stared steadily at us as in the dusk. Beneath the new moon, men look at each other. They knit their brows and squinted at us just as an old tailor at his needle's eye. And when that family looked harder, I was recognized by one who took me by the hem and cried out, "This is marvelous." That spirit, having stretched his arm toward me, I fixed my eyes upon his baked brown features so that the scorching of his face could not prevent my mind from recognizing him, and lowering my face to meet his face, I answered him, "Are you here, Sir Brunetto?" And he, "My son, do not mind if Brunetto Latino lingers for a while with you and lets the file he's with pass on ahead." I said, "With all my strength, I pray you stay, and if you'd have me rest a while with you, I shall, if that please him with whom I go." "Oh, son," he said, "whoever of this flock stops but at a moment, stays 100 years and cannot shield himself when fire strikes. Therefore, move on below, but close, I'll follow, and then I shall rejoin my company who go lamenting their eternal sorrows." I did not dare to leave my path for his own level, but I walked with the head bent low as does a man who goes in reverence. And he began, "What destiny or chance has led you here below before your last day came, and who is he who shows the way?" "There, in the sunlit life above," I answered, "before my years were full, I went astray within a valley. Only yesterday at dawn I turned my back upon it, but when I was newly lost, he here appeared to guide me home again along this path. And he to me, 'If you pursue your star, you cannot fail to reach a splendid harbor, if in fair life. I judged you properly, and if I had not died too soon for this, unseen heaven was so kind to you, I should have helped sustain you in your work. But that malicious, that ungrateful people come down in ancient times from Faisol, Fiesole, still keeping something of the rock and mountain, for your good deeds will be your enemy, and there is cause among the sour sorbs. The sweet fig is not meant to bear its fruit. The world has long since called them blind, and people presumptuous, avaricious, envious. Be sure to cleanse yourself of their foul ways. Your fortune holds in store such honor for you. One party and the other will be hungry for you, but keep the grass far from the goat. For let the beasts of Faisal find forage among themselves, and leave the plant alone if still among their dung it rises up, in which there lives again the sacred seed of those few Romans who remained in Florence when such a nest of wickedness was built." "If my desire were answered totally," I said to Sir Brunetto, "you still be among, not banished from humanity. Within my memory is fixed, and now moves me, your dear, your kind paternal image, when, in the world above, from time to time, you taught me how man makes himself eternal. And while I live, my gratitude for that must always be apparent in my words. What you have told me of my course I write, I keep it with another text for comment by one who will understand, if I may reach her. One thing alone I have you plainly see, so long as I am not rebuked by conscience, I stand prepared for fortune, come what may. My ears find no new pledge in that prediction. Therefore, let fortune turn her will as she may please, and let the peasant turn his mattock, M-A-T-T-O-C-K. At this, my master turned his head around and toward the right and looked at me and said, he who takes note of this has listened well. But nonetheless, my talk with Sir Brunetto continues, and I ask of him who are his comrades of repute and excellence. And he to me, to know of some is good, but for the rest, silence is to be praised. The time we have is short for so much talk. In brief, know that my company has clerics and men of letters and of fame, and all were stained by one same sin upon the earth. That sorry crowd holds Precision and Francesco de Accorso, and among them you..." So this is Precision, or Priscian, P-R-I-S-C-I-A-N-N, Francesco di Accorso, and among them you can see if you have any longing for such scurf, the one the servant of his servant sent from the Arno to the Bacaglione's banks, and there he left his tendons strained by sin. I would say more, but both my walk and words must be not be longer. For beyond I see new smoke emerging from the sandy bed. Now people come with whom I must not be. Now people come with whom I must not be. Let my tesoro, in which I still live, be precious to you, and I ask no more. And then he turned and seemed like one of those who race across the fields to win the green cloth of Verona. Of those runners, he appeared to be the winner, not the loser. So his guide left him? I don't know, we'll see. All right, that was the end of Canto 15.